earnings season is winding down, and you know what that means? The retailers. And we're getting a lot of them again this week and next week after Labor Day. And I'll be covering all of them. So you want to be sure to tune in to all of these videos, because I'm going to pick out the best, the ones that you should be keeping an eye on. Those might not have the best charts, by the way, but some do. And who are the king of the retailers right now? What are they doing right that the others are not? I'm going to look into all of it, and we're going to take a look with five of the top retailers you need to be watching this week. Let's see what they are. So the first one out the gate is Tiffany. Now, I brought this one not because it has the best chart, but they do have a great track record of beating here with their last miss back in 2016. But as you can see, the stock is down this year again. Looks like it's heading towards possibly those 2018 December lows. And some of that is because the tourist industry is still really weak. And we saw this with Macy's in their report, that these flagship stores that they have in major cities like New York City really see a lot of business from the tourism industry. And if the tourists are down and or not spending, then Tiffany and Macy's can get hit. So we'll see what they report this time. They are pretty cheap here, but not as cheap as they have been in the past, about 16 times earnings right here. But if these shares go lower, could be looking at a nice value play. Now, switching over to someone with a much better chart, and that's Five Below. So it's been pretty rocky since that December 2018 sell-off. They have the great track record of meeting or beating every quarter, as you can see, since our data began in 2016. But it's getting a little bit volatile here, you might say. And they're not cheap. These shares are trading at about 35 times. So maybe that's contributing to the volatility here. But Five Below, one of the more popular of the retailers. And one of its big customers are the tweens and the teens. So this one will be interesting. Then we're going to switch over to one of the apparel giants. And this is PVH. Now, it has a great track record. It hasn't missed in 5 years. That's pretty rare for most of the retailers. But they, as you can see, these shares are, you know, just sinking even worse than the December sell-off. And that's making them extremely cheap. I believe these shares are oversold here. But PVH owns Calvin Klein, Tommy Hilfiger. They do have big business in China, not just making the product there and shipping it around the world, but they also are a big retailer there. So kind of dual worries going on here, but are the worries overdone? We're gonna find out. But again, these shares are among the cheapest of the retailers right here. Then we're gonna switch over to another big winner on the retail side, Ollie's. Ollie's Bargain Basement. If you don't know them, it's because you're not in the Pennsylvania area where they are predominantly have most of their stores in that region, but they have been killing it since their IPO in 2015. As you can see, they haven't missed yet. And yeah, we had the sell-off again in these shares in 2018, but big rebound to new highs and coming down a little bit, making them a little bit more affordable. But we'll see what happens with this earnings report. They are pretty expensive here as well. So some of these more glamorous retailers that are making new highs are not cheap. This one's trading at 36 times. Then we're going to switch over to one of my favorites on the, I guess you could call it kind of the discounter side, and that is Burlington. And yes, everybody still calls it Burlington Coat Factory, but they're much more than coats now. So they're just sticking with the Burlington. And they have only just that one miss in last quarter, going back 5 years now. And you can see the shares have maybe stalled out a little bit after this big, massive rally over the last 5 years, but they did break out to new highs not that long ago. So can this one keep the momentum? Can it regain its beating ability? We're going to see. So as you can see, a lot is going on this week with the retailers. This is only a select few of the ones that I'm going to be watching all week long and into next week. So be sure to check out all of our videos on the retailers. There's going to be a lot going on, and you can get them all on Zacks.com/YouTube and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss a single one. But I'll be back again with some more retails.